Hello everyone. In part 3 of microprocessor and interfacing devices, in this video I am going to explain architecture of microprocessor 8086, which is a 16-bit microprocessor. So 8086, this 8086 is a 16-bit microprocessor. 16-bit microprocessor means its data bus size is 16-bit. And it is designed by Intel. 8086 is designed by Intel. It is 40-pin IC. It is 40-pin IC. This IC of 8086 is shown out here. You can see 20 pins on one side and 20 pins on other side. So this pin diagram we are going to learn in detail in some other video. So right now only just see, this is a 40-pin IC pin configuration of 8086. So Intel also designed, after 8086, Intel also designed 8087, 8286, 386, etc. And hence, 86 is Intel's most successful line of processor. Why? Because it was having an ability to control all operations, taking all decisions, and hence this processor is included in almost all university syllabus. This is architecture of 8086. Architecture means what? Architecture means block diagram of microprocessor 8086. You can see here this block diagram is divided into two parts. This is upper part and this is lower part. And this is data bus. It is data bus. Okay. So this upper portion of 8086 is known as bus interface unit. And this portion is known as execution unit. In short, it is written EU. EU means execution unit and bus interface unit, that is BIU. So what these two does? What is the function of bus interface unit and execution unit? So bus interface unit generates 20-bit physical address for memory access. Memory access means for receiving a data from memory. It fetches instructions from memory. It transfers data to and from memory and input-output devices, maintains the 6-byte prefetch instruction. So what is written? What bus interface unit does? Bus interface unit ye memory ka address generate karta hai, memory ka address send karta hai address bus pe, aur memory se data aur instruction fetch karta hai. Fetching karna yane leke aata hai apne paas. So these are the functions of bus interface unit. This again I will explain in detail in next slide. And what execution unit does? Execution unit is responsible for execution of instruction. Jo instruction bus interface unit leke aata hai, uska execution kon karega? Execution unit. So what bus interface unit does? Bus interface unit fetches the instruction. And what execution unit does? It executes the instruction fetched by bus interface unit. Execution unit also tells bus interface unit from where to fetch the instruction. Wo jo instruction hai memory mein kahan save ki hui hai aur kahan se use leke aana hai, ye kaun batayega? Ye execution unit batata hai bus interface unit ko. So how it takes place? Let's see. Again, this is same architecture of 8086. It is divided into two parts, that is bus interface unit and execution unit. What I said, what bus interface unit does? Bus interface unit generates 20-bit physical address for memory access. Memory access. Memory access karna hai, yani kya hai? Memory mein koi to instruction saved hai ya phir data saved hai, use leke aana. Use kya bolte hai? Memory access. So bus interface unit generates 20-bit physical address for memory access and it fetches instruction from the memory. Aur kya karta hai? Wo leke aata hai. Kaise leke aata hai? Dekhte. So ye memory hai. Okay. So memory is not the internal part of architecture of 8086. Ye hume alag se connect karni padti hai. Jaise mobile mein hum log memory alag se chip dalte hai na, waise hi 8086 mein bhi ye memory alag se hume connect karni hoti hai. So it fetches instructions from the memory. So this is your memory. Suppose this is any memory location. As I already told you, memory consists of registers. Aur har ek register ko kya bolte hai? Memory location. suppose 20000 is address of this memory location. 8086 always have 20-bit address. 20-bit address. So suppose this is address of this location. And suppose this is data stored in the register. ये क्या है? Data है और ये क्या है? Address है. तो अब ये address कौन generate करेगा? Bus interface unit generate करेगा ये address. तो इस यहाँ पे बस इंटरफेस यूनिट ने ये एड्रेस जनरेट किया क्योंकि उसे यहाँ से ये डेटा इस लोकेशन से डेटा फेच करना है या इंस्ट्रक्शन है तो इंस्ट्रक्शन फेच करना है. देन इट विल सेंड इट टू द नेक्स्ट लोकेशन हियर एंड नाउ इट हैज टू सेंड इट ऑन एड्रेस बस. सो व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज एड्रेस बस विच इज कनेक्टेड टू मेमोरी. सी एड्रेस बस इज ऑलवेज यूनिडायरेक्शनल. Now this bus interface unit will send this address on address bus like this. So it is sending this address to the memory. Abhi address memory ke paas aa gaya hai. So on this address what is saved? This is data. Now data should flow on data bus, not on address bus. Okay. So let's assume that this is our address bus, which is denoted by green color, drawn by green color. Now this data will flow on data bus. Towards microprocessor. और कहाँ जाएगा आने के बाद? Here you can see it is a 6-byte prefetch queue. This is known as instruction queue. So what happens? See this fetch instruction, it will get saved into this instruction queue. So see ये कहाँ गया? यहाँ पे. And after this what is written? Bus interface unit generates 20-bit physical address for memory access. It fetches instruction from memory. This I have shown. It has generated this address here. Then it has sent this address to the memory. And then it has fetched this instruction and saved it in the queue. What execution unit does? Execution unit is responsible for execution of instruction. So this execution unit will simply take this instruction from queue and execute this instruction. So execution unit need not to fetch it from memory. What bus interface unit does? Bus interface unit will fetch this instruction and execution unit will simply take it from the queue and will execute. Now what are the features of 8086? 8086 is 16-bit microprocessor having 20 address lines and 16 data lines. Obviously, whenever it is said that it is a 16-bit microprocessor, that itself indicates that the data lines, data address size is 16-bit. Data lines are 16. There are 16 wires for data lines. Okay. And it's every word, each word of 16-bit microprocessor, every register consists of 16-bit. That is the meaning of 16-bit microprocessor. And it has 20-bit address line. It has 20-bit address line. Means how many address lines are there? How many address wires are there? 20 address wires are there. So how do we calculate? In my previous video, I have already explained you how to calculate the number of memory locations that can be addressed by using these address lines. So address bus size is given, that is 20-bit. So this is memory size. What M indicates? Memory size. It is equal to 2^n. The formula is 2^n, wherein n is number of lines. So here it is 20. So it is equals to 1048576 and it is approximately 1 MB of memory. So, to this 16-bit 8086 microprocessor, we can connect memory only up to 1 MB. You cannot connect 2 MB, 3 MB, 4 MB memory to 8086. Why? Because this address line limits the capacity of memory that we can connect to the microprocessor. Again, it has instruction queue. Again, I am explaining this instruction queue operation in the next slide in detail. It has an instruction queue which is capable of storing 6 instruction bytes from the memory, resulting in faster processing. माइक्रोप्रोसेसर क्या करता है, मेमोरी में 6 इंस्ट्रक्शन स्टोर किया हुआ है उसे पहले ही फेच करके क्यू में रख देता है। और फिर एग्जीक्यूशन यूनिट क्या करता है, एग्जीक्यूशन यूनिट क्यू में से एक एक इंस्ट्रक्शन लेके उसका एग्जीक्यूशन करेगा। ओके, सो इट वॉज द फर्स्ट 8086 वॉज द फर्स्ट 16 बिट माइक्रो प्रोसेसर हैविंग 16 बिट अर्थमेटिक एंड लॉजिकल यूनिट, 16 बिट रजिस्टर्स, इंटरनल डेटा बस एंड 16 बिट एक्सटर्नल डेटा बस, रिजल्टिंग इन फास्टर ऑपरेशन। सो 8086 इज द फर्स्ट 16 बिट माइक्रोप्रोसेसर। उसके पहले कितना बिट का माइक्रोप्रोसेसर था, 8 बिट का था। दैट वॉज ऑल्सो इंटेल्स 8085 माइक्रोप्रोसेसर। दैट माइक्रोप्रोसेसर इज ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी सक्सेसफुल एंड हैविंग वेरी गुड डिजाइन। बट 8086 वॉज द फर्स्ट हैविंग 16 बिट रजिस्टर्स, 16 bit data bus, etc. And that's why the operation is faster. 8086 is available in 3 versions. So these are 3 different operating frequencies of 8086. It operates on 5 MHz, 8 MHz and 10 MHz. Okay. It supports pipelined architecture. What is meaning of it supports pipelined architecture? Meaning of pipelined architecture means when bus interface unit fetches the instructions from the memory, simultaneously at the same time execution unit executes the previously fetched instruction. क्या होता है, बस इंटरफेस यूनिट ने 6 instructions लाके क्यू में रख दी, अब एग्जीक्यूशन यूनिट को क्या करना है, सिर्फ क्यू से लेके एग्जीक्यूट करना है। तो एग्जीक्यूशन यूनिट क्यू में से इंस्ट्रक्शन लेके एग्जीक्यूट कर रहा है और बस इंटरफेस यूनिट एक एक इंस्ट्रक्शन लाके क्यू में रख रहा है। तो दोनों ऑपरेशंस पैरेलली चल रहे, फेचिंग ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन फ्रॉम द मेमोरी एंड एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन इज टेकिंग प्लेस साइमल्टेनियसली। एंड सिंस इट इज साइमल्टेनियस, दिस टाइप ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर दैट सपोर्ट्स दिस साइमल्टेनियस ऑपरेशन इज नोन एज पाइपलाइन architecture. It has 256 vectored interrupts. Again, we need to learn it in detail in coming videos. Now, there are general purpose registers. In 8086, there are general purpose registers. How many general purpose registers are there? You can see 1, 2, 3, 4. Do you remember this? It is there in the block diagram of 8086, in the architecture of 8086. There are 4 16-bit register. Size of this AX is 16-bit, BX is 16-bit, CX is 16-bit, DX is 16-bit. Size is 16-bit because it is a 16-bit register. And every register is divided into 8-bit and 8-bit. So there is, if you want, you can use them either as 8-bit register or as 16-bit register. इस तरह से arrangement है, तो अगर आपको 16-bit word store करना है, तो आप BX में स्टोर करो, और अगर आपको 8-bit वर्ड स्टोर करना है तो आप BL या BH में करो। सो दैट प्रोविजन इज अवेलेबल। सी, दिस इज नॉट डिफरेंट, BX, BL, BH डिफरेंट नहीं है, BH एंड BL इज अ पार्ट ऑफ BX ओनली। ओके, अगर आपको 16-bit का वर्ड सेव करना है तो आप पूरा BX यूज करोगे, अगर आपको 8-bit के लिए यूज करना है रजिस्टर तो आप BL या BH यूज करो। ओके, सो दीज आर जनरल पर्पज registers. Now, what is the main use of this register? Generally, these registers are used for storing data, okay, before, after arithmetic and logical operations. So, what AX register does, these are some special use of these registers along with normal general purpose registers. It holds operands and result during multiplication and division operation. What AX does, AX holds the result of arithmetic and logical operation. और multiplication और division करना है तो एक जो operand होता है, एक जो दूसरा number होता है, operand मतलब दूसरा number, वो भी AX register में रहेगा. Okay, BX register क्या करता है, it holds the offset address in indirect addressing mode. अभी आपको ये offset address का meaning नहीं समझ में आएगा जब तक हम लोग memory segmentation नहीं पढ़ेंगे, तो बस अभी के लिए इतना ही याद रखो कि ये ऑफसेट एड्रेस होल्ड करता है। CX रजिस्टर होल्ड्स द काउंट फॉर इंस्ट्रक्शन। काउंट फॉर इंस्ट्रक्शन मीन्स इसके प्रोग्रामिंग में जब भी हम लोग लूप लगाते हैं, लूप लगाने के लिए कितने बार लूप घूमना चाहिए उसके लिए वो जो काउंट होता है वो हमेशा CX रजिस्टर में ही स्टोर होता है. DX रजिस्टर इट इज यूज्ड विद AX टू होल्ड 32 बिट वैल्यू ड्यूरिंग मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिविजन instruction. So whenever we will be learning the instruction set of 8086, that time all these ideas will get more clear and you will very clearly understand the application of these general purpose registers. Now what is the instruction queue? So I told you instruction queue is there in bus interface unit. So while execution unit is busy in decoding the instruction, that means decoding and execution of instruction, bus interface unit fetches the next 6 instruction bytes from the location. The locations are mentioned out here and then it saves. So, ek example ke saath dekhte hai ki suppose this is your memory. Okay, ya niche bhi memory hai aur upar bhi hai registers. It memory again consists of registers and this is instruction stored in memory locations. Okay, and suppose here there is and these are the addresses, 20 bit addresses of this memory locations. So size of every register is 1 byte. 1 byte means 8 bits. Okay, so you can see 8 bits are stored in every location. Suppose right now execution unit is executing this instruction. This is already sent. That means it is already sent to the queue. Execution unit has already received it from the queue, and suppose let us assume that execution unit is executing this instruction. Okay, so what are next 6 instructions? Then next instructions will be the instructions stored from 2001 location to 2006 location. So what bus interface unit does? Bus interface, suppose this is bus interface unit mein ye hai queue. Suppose this is 6 byte queue. Okay, aur ye kahan mein hoti hai? Bus interface unit mein. To ye kya karega bus interface unit jab ye instruction ka execution chal raha hai, jab is instruction ka execution chal raha hai us time pe ye 6 instruction it will fetch and keep it in the queue. तो ये जो इंस्ट्रक्शन है 2001 वो सबसे नीचे आ जाएगा जो क्यू का फर्स्ट लोकेशन है एंड इट विल गेट ट्रांसफर्ड लाइक दिस द बाइट्स विल गेट ट्रांसफर्ड लाइक दिस यू कैन सी नाउ दीज लाइंस विद एरोज आर ओनली फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग पर्पस Remember these lines are only for understanding purpose. Actually data flows, these instructions on data will flow through data bus. These are going to flow through data bus aur ek ke baad ye sirf understanding ke lines hai, itni data buses nahi hoti hai. Okay, so it will fetch one by one and it will keep it in the queue. Now it has kept it in the queue. अब क्या है नीचे क्या होता है बस इंटरफेस यूनिट के एग्जीक्यूशन यूनिट तो ये डेटा बस है एग्जीक्यूशन यूनिट की तो यहाँ से फर्स्ट इन फर्स्ट आउट बेसिस पे चलता है सी हियर इट इज रिटन दीज इंस्ट्रक्शन बाइट्स आर स्टोर्ड इन 6 byte क्यू ऑन द फर्स्ट इन फर्स्ट आउट बेसिस यानी जो इंस्ट्रक्शन सबसे पहले आई है वो सबसे पहले एग्जीक्यूशन यूनिट में जाएगी सबसे पहले कौन सी आई थी ये रेड वाली ये वाला सबसे पहले आया था तो ये कहाँ जाएगा सबसे पहले एग्जीक्यूशन यूनिट में जाएगा फॉर एग्जीक्यूशन सो दिस इज हाउ दिस इंस्ट्रक्शन क्यू वर्क्स विथ मेमोरी और इंटरैक्ट्स विथ मेमोरी एंड दिस इज द यूज ऑफ एग्जीक्यूशन दिस इज द यूज ऑफ क्यू नाउ अरिथमेटिक एंड लॉजिक यूनिट एंड फ्लैग्स सो दिस इज अरिथमेटिक एंड लॉजिकल यूनिट इट इज इन एग्जीक्यूशन यूनिट Okay, and these are flags. Again, we are going to learn flags in detail. Just remember that arithmetic and logical unit, again, its size is 16-bit and it is used for performing arithmetic and logical operations on 16-bit data. Now, what is flag? Okay, flag register is a special purpose register. The size of flag register is 16 bits. See, this is 16 bit register, लेकिन सारे के सारे 16 bits use नहीं किए हुए हैं, कुछ ही use किए हुए हैं. Depending upon the value of the result after any arithmetic and logical operation, the flag bits become 0 or 1. What happens whenever we perform arithmetic and logical operation on 8-bit, 16-bit of data? Based on the result of arithmetic and logical operation, these bits will set or reset. Flag क्या करता है? Status बताता है कि addition के बाद क्या हुआ. वो बता तो नहीं सकता है ना, माइक्रोप्रोसेसर cannot speak, he cannot tell us what happened. लेकिन अगर हमें देखना है कि अंदर क्या हो रहा है, मैंने तो दो नंबर एडिशन के लिए दे दिए, अब अंदर क्या हो रहा है वो अगर मुझे देखना है तो what we can do, we can check the status of flags. So flags is a special purpose register that shows the status after arithmetical and logical operations. So out of this flags, these five flags, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are known as status flags, and these flags are control flags. Okay. Now let's see one by one. This is our flags and these are explained in detail. Let's start with the carry flag. Okay. What carry flag does? 1, carry out of MSB, and 0, no such carry. What is the meaning of this? Suppose we have two numbers. Let me take the pen down. Now suppose we have two numbers. Okay. And we are adding these two numbers. So I will get this 0 plus 1, 1, then all zeros, and here it is 1 plus 1, 0. And this is one additional bit. What is this additional bit? This is carry generated after addition. This is extra bit generated due to carry after addition. So, agar ye generate hota hai, suppose carry generates after arithmetic and logical operation, then carry flag will set to 1. अदरवाइज अगर ये कैरी नहीं जनरेट होता तो कैरी फ्लैग क्या होता, जीरो होता. अंडरस्टूड. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज पैरिटी फ्लैग. नाउ हियर आई हैव शोन अगेन देयर आर टू नंबर्स, दिस इज 8-bit नंबर एंड दिस इज अनदर 8-bit नंबर्स. नाउ दिस इज एंड ऑपरेशन, लॉजिकल ऑपरेशन, नॉट नेसेसरी दैट इट शुड बी ऑलवेज एडिशन और एंड ऑपरेशन. आई सेड इट इज आफ्टर एनी अर्थमेटिक एंड लॉजिकल ऑपरेशन. तो एंड है 111, 000, 111 एंड 001. व्हाट पैरिटी फ्लैग, दिस पीएफ स्टैंड्स फॉर पैरिटी फ्लैग. इन द रिजल्ट आफ्टर अर्थमेटिक एंड लॉजिकल ऑपरेशन, इफ नंबर ऑफ वंस आर इवन, इट इज पैरिटी फ्लैग. इफ नंबर ऑफ वंस आर इवन, सी 1, 2, 3, 4, सो इवन नंबर ऑफ वंस. इफ देर इज अ इवन पैरिटी इन द रिजल्ट, देन पैरिटी फ्लैग विल सेट टू 1. क्लियर. अगर यहाँ पे ये 1 नहीं होता, ये कुछ और होता, ये 0 होता, अगर ये नंबर भी 0 होता और ये 1 प्लस 1 0 होता, तो ये ऑड होते. अगर ये ऑड होते तो पैरिटी फ्लैग 0. ओके. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज ऑक्सिलरी कैरी फ्लैग. व्हाट इज ऑक्सिलरी कैरी फ्लैग? इट इज 1 व्हेन कैरी फ्रॉम लोअर निबल टू हायर निबल जनरेट्स. Again, after arithmetic and logical operation, again we are assuming 8-bit number and 8-bit number, and this is addition of number. After addition, if carry generates from lower nibble to higher nibble, see here 1 plus 1, ye 4-bit ka kya nibble hai? 1 plus 1 is 1, 0. So 0 yahan rakha aur 1 yahan pe aa gaya as a carry. If carry generates from lower nibble, then carry then auxiliary carry flag will set to 1, otherwise auxiliary carry flag is 0. Agar yahan pe ye 1 na hoke, agar ye 0 hota aur yahan pe ye 1 plus 0, agar ye 1 hota aur yahan se carry generate na hota, to auxiliary carry flag kya hota? 0. Understood. Next is zero flag. After arithmetic and logical operation, after arithmetic and logical operation, if result is 0, if result is 0, then zero flag will set to 1. Let's take this example. Isme result kya hai? Non-zero hai. We have added these two numbers, say, and result is non-zero. If result is non-zero, then zero flag will be 0. And if result is 0, after arithmetic and logical operation, if result is 0, then 0 flag will be 1. okay, lekin for this example it is 0. Then what is sign flag? Again this example is shown addition of two numbers. What is sign flag? This MSB, most significant bit. If this most significant bit is 1, then it indicates that this number is negative. And if this number is negative, sign flag will set to 1. Okay. After arithmetic and logical operation, if most significant bit means this bit. If this bit is 0, then it indicates that this result is positive. And if result is positive, then sign flag will be 0. But simple, kaise yaad rakhna hai? After arithmetic and logical operation, agar most significant bit 0 hai, to sign flag 0. Or most significant bit 1 hai, to sign flag 1. Lekin uska meaning pata hona chahiye, why 1 and why 0? Because when MSB is 1, it indicates number is negative. And when MSB is 0, it indicates that number is positive. If number is negative, sign flag is 1. If number is positive, sign flag is 0. Next flag is trap flag. Now control flags. Trap flag is 1. It performs single stepping. Now, ye hame set ya reset karna hai. ये वाले क्या थे स्टेटस ये खुद चेंज हो रहे थे अकॉर्डिंग टू द रिजल्ट ऑफ अरिथमेटिक एंड लॉजिकल ऑपरेशन लेकिन ये वाले जो फ्लैग्स है ये हमें चेंज करना है यूजर को चेंज करना है प्रोग्रामर को चेंज करना है एज पर हिज रिक्वायरमेंट द फर्स्ट ऑफ कंट्रोल इज ट्रैप फ्लैग इफ इट इज 1 इट परफॉर्म सिंगल स्टेपिंग व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ सिंगल स्टेपिंग सिंगल स्टेपिंग में क्या होता है व्हेन यू राइट अ प्रोग्राम फॉर माइक्रो प्रोसेसर इट एंड इफ दीज आर इंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑफ प्रोग्राम देन आफ्टर एवरी इंस्ट्रक्शन इट विल शो यू द रिजल्ट व्हाट आर द कंटेंट्स ऑफ रजिस्टर व्हाट इज रिजल्ट और अगर ये 0 रखा अगर ट्रैप फ्लैग हमने 0 रखा तो क्या करेगा ये पहले पूरा प्रोग्राम एग्जीक्यूट होने देगा और पूरा प्रोग्राम एग्जीक्यूट होने के बाद ही हम देख पाएंगे कि कौन से रजिस्टर में क्या वैल्यू है और क्या रिजल्ट है अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ सिंगल स्टेपिंग नंबर सी सिंगल स्टेपिंग यानी क्या एवरी स्टेप के बाद एवरी इंस्ट्रक्शन के बाद आप रिजल्ट देख सकते हो रजिस्टर के कंटेंट्स चेंज होते देख सकते हो और अगर 0 है तो नॉन सिंगल स्टेपिंग तो क्या होगा पूरा प्रोग्राम पहले एग्जीक्यूट करेगा और उसके बाद ही आप देख पाओगे कि व्हाट आर द कंटेंट्स ऑफ रजिस्टर्स दिस इज इंटरप्ट फ्लैग व्हाट इंटरप्ट फ्लैग सेज इफ इट इज 1 इट विल एनेबल द इंटरप्ट एंड इफ इट इज 0 इट विल डिसेबल ऑल इंटरप्ट ओके ये इंटरप्ट का कॉन्सेप्ट जो है ये बहुत ही बड़ा और मुश्किल कॉन्सेप्ट होता है टू अंडरस्टैंड The meaning of this statement, again, you need to learn or view one more video that I will be making of interrupts. And then only you will understand meaning of this. Again, this is direction flag. Direction flag says if it is 1, it is auto increment. If it is 0, if it is 1, it is auto decrement. And if it is 0, it is auto increment it is used in string type of instruction so whenever I will be explaining you the string instructions that time I will make you understand meaning of the direction flag and what is the meaning of this one means auto decrement and zero means auto increment iska meaning kya hai kab pata chalega jab hum log string instructions padhenge next is overflow flag what is overflow flag It is 1 when overflow occurred and it is 0 when no overflow occurred. Overflow is calculated as C7 example or C6. What is meaning? Again here you can see if it is addition of two numbers and if there is an overflow of result, then also overflow flag will set to 1. Okay. And what is difference in carry flag and overflow flag then? Carry flag we can set or reset by instructions as well. It is not necessary that it will get set or reset always after arithmetic and logical operations. Now segment registers and offset. Now you see, you have seen this bus interface unit. There are these registers. This is known as code segment register, stack segment register, data segment register, extra segment register, and instruction pointer. And in execution unit, there are pointer registers, that is stack pointer, base pointer, source index registers, and destination index register. The size of all these registers are 16 bit. The size of these pointers are also 16 bits. Now, actually, use of these registers and how they work together for calculation of 20-bit physical address, that you will understand when I will explain you the memory segmentation, the concept of memory segmentation, how memory is segmented, and how to calculate 20-bit physical address. Right now, just understand that there are four segment registers, that these are four segment registers, and these are pointer registers. There are memory can be divided into four segments, that is code segment, data segment, extra segment, and stack segment. Agar code segment ka jo memory hai uska agar hame address generate karna hai to hame combination lena padega CSR aur IP ka. अगर डेटा सेगमेंट का चाहिए तो हमें करना पड़ेगा डीएसआर और सोर्स इंडेक्स का कॉम्बिनेशन. अगर एक्स्ट्रा सेगमेंट की जो मेमोरी है उसका अगर हमें एड्रेस जनरेट करना है तो हमें चाहिए ये कॉम्बिनेशन. और अगर हमें स्टैक सेगमेंट का एड्रेस जनरेट करना है तो चाहिए हमें ये कॉम्बिनेशन. लेकिन ये कॉम्बिनेशन कैसे वर्क करता है दैट यू विल अंडरस्टैंड इन द कमिंग वीडियोस. थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग. आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड. इफ यू हैव एनी क्यूरीज यू कैन राइट इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. थैंक्स अगेन.